Okay, first of all, the whole John Doe spooky story and any of its variations are completely false, as made clear on several occasions by several people. The rumors of everyone being hacked on a particular day a few months ago were spread by generic YouTubers to get some easy views. Given the YouTuber War Tycoon was built as a generic bad Roblox game to observe how it does, I added the John Doe code to get some easy visits. It was also to test some spooky filtering-enabled concepts to which the game was switched before that. Filtering-enabled means the client cannot replicate to the server, which in a human language means that if an exploiter makes changes to the game on his computer, these changes will not affect the game itself and other players. This also means that using local scripts, the game can make changes to an individual player's game without affecting the others, which was the basic concept of the whole event. During the weekend, when the mass hacking by John Doe was allegedly supposed to take place, the John Doe code in the game had a 50% chance to trigger it for every player. As a result, half people were playing the game perfectly normally and did not understand why the other half was writing scat messages in the chat. It was pretty great. Nowadays, the code can only be triggered manually through the code input window. We'll look at how it works. On the left is a player with the spooky code activated, on the right, a normal player. This whole thing is not very sophisticated or clever. It's similar to the common creepypastas and bad horror games, as in, it employs unexpected sudden occurrences to spook the player, in other words, jump scares. After the initial crude announcement GUI disappears, there is a small pause and a bit of a lighting glitch. After that, the player is left sort of clueless as to what happened, and nothing really occurs for some time, giving them the illusion that maybe that was all. The time periods until the next stage of the spooky script activates are random. This is there to make sure two people can't activate it simultaneously and get to the last area at the same time. This is to prevent spooky secrets from being easily accessible. Yes, there are secrets, but they are very difficult to activate and not rewarding at all. Then that happens. That's really the best laugh I found in the asset library. The messages during the transition are randomly chosen and generally not very imaginative. At this point, you can see the lighting changes permanently and the music is a bit different. The buttons previously used by currency now also have randomly generated messages. Naturally, the regular player is not going to see any of this, as the changes are only made to one client. This one, honestly, doesn't do much. It is a spooky secret check, and in order for it to do something the player can notice, it removes some of the GUI elements. Nothing too interesting. The currency buying buttons do not work naturally. Music can still be changed. Not anymore. The music, whatever it was, changes to a specific one set by the script. The music buttons start doing the same thing as the currency buying buttons, that is, have really poorly written text cycled slowly and randomly on them. Partially, they are also stupid as they hold some coded messages of their own. As far as I can tell, the game reported that at the time of recording, only three players encountered one of the less obtuse secrets, and most of those were never discovered. I would not suggest to go looking for them, though. Again, they are all really stupid, the solution doesn't make sense and is way too complex, and the reward is really garbage. This stage is called Darkness, understandably. Only the skybox changes to night. We even have the moon. The regular player, naturally, is still enjoying sunshine. The two players are not apart, however. The idea is that the affected player is experiencing the spookening, but can still interact with other players in the server, chat confusingly, mostly. That's the intended behavior, but they can still interact with others as they normally would. This transition is not too interesting. Only a darker shade of lighting to give the player an idea that things are progressively getting worse. As said, The regular player still sees the affected player moving around the map, and things like damage can still be dealt. Maybe another secret, No. This is a better one. The player is teleported to the underground. The regular player sees the other player disappeared. The funny thing is that on its own that's not too bad, but after a few seconds the torches and all light in the underground tunnels disappear. This can make it hard to get out. Originally I intended to script in some kind of monster or spooky punishment if the player would not get out in time, but eventually did not have that much time to put this whole thing together. After all, it's just a crudely made code set pretending to be scary based on a really stupid internet hoax, so I didn't look too much into it or revisit it to add new things after the original event was over. I think the idea is fairly interesting though. A multiplayer game with this as its premise, the players experiencing different things, could be pretty cool. The underground marked the interesting part. From here it's mostly flavor because of the time limitations I had when making this. Here the water just turns red. That's about the extent of it. Nothing else really happens for some time until the last phase starts. The player is teleported in front of the main statue for a reason. Note, this isn't supposed to imply the female statue is responsible, it was just added after this event was scripted and thus isn't affected. If you can notice, the sky is also a bit red at this point. Here, only the last part of the GUI remains. It is supposed to be typed in, but to be sure, in case some people don't get it, the next stage will start automatically after some time. As you can see, the regular player, GUI included, is perfectly fine throughout all of this. To progress here, we will type something in the GUI, which, like the regular feedback window, sends it to our Discord. This gets us to the final area. The message goes into regular feedback. When someone finds a secret, it goes into a special spooky channel. Back in the game, more random messages. The final area is very dark, but explorable. Also secrets, or a secret rather. More messages, that's the only trick I know. And there's an Overwatch Ultimate. After a brief pause, the final jump scare occurs, which looks really ugly and is put together only from a few random images I found on the site. When it occurs, the player is kicked out of the game and given a commemorative badge. That's the jump scare sound at least. But yeah, that concludes the John Doe code. The other player is still fine and completely unaffected. Not sure why you would, but if you'd like to see this in-game after watching the video, simply put John Doe into the game's code interface and don't search for the secrets. It really is not worth it. If you find one and are going to be disappointed, don't tell me I didn't say so.